Hello friends, welcome to GT Science tutorial. In this video, I am going to explain about entropy change for isothermal reversible and irreversible process. We know that for every reaction, entropy changes. But how does it change for reversible and irreversible process? In this video, we are going to see everything about that. So let's start. To understand about the given topic, let us consider a cylinder which is fitted with a weightless and frictionless piston. This is that weightless and frictionless piston, and in which the substance is put. This is the substance, and these are the molecules of the substance is put, and this is simply called as the system. And this is put in a large heat reservoir. Heat reservoir can give it heat, or it can take heat from the system as well. This is the heat reservoir, and it is perfectly isolated from the surrounding. This is the bar, or this isolates the system from the surrounding. That means heat cannot enter nor get out from that barrier. This is the barrier, or simply we can say that heat exchange will be zero in this case. We are considering a system in which there is a cylinder containing weightless and frictionless piston, and that contains the given substance. These are the molecules of the substance that is called system, and it is surrounded by, or it is put in a large heat reservoir which can provide it heat, or we can take heat from it as well. Similarly, this is separated from the surrounding by a perfectly insulated barrier. That barrier does not allow the heat to transmit through it. So heat exchange will be zero. That's why it is called isolated system. So we are going to study the entropy change in this particular case. First of all, let's see the entropy change for isothermal reversible process. For isothermal reversible process, let us consider this substance is being expanded. That means this piston is coming up. When it comes up, the substance inside the cylinder will expand, and that happens because it gets some heating energy from the heat reservoir. So in this particular case, this heat reservoir will give heat energy to the molecules, and they will expand, right? So in this particular case, the system, that means these molecules will gain heat energy, and the reservoir will lose heat energy. Let me write something over here. Let us consider the substance inside the cylinder undergoes expansion from V1 to V2. Volume has been changed from V1 to V2 by gaining QR amount of heat from heat reservoir. It gets energy from the heat reservoir, right? So in this particular case, the entropy change of substance, will be that is del S1 will be equal to QR by T. it will be positive because the system is gaining heat energy, and when it gets heat energy, its entropy will increase, and entropy is positive. So the entropy change of the substance, that is the system, will be QR by T. The reservoir is losing the heat, so its entropy change will be del S2 will be equal to minus QR by T. As the reservoir losing heat energy, that means its entropy is decreasing and it will be negative. Therefore, the total entropy change during expansion is, that is, del S will be equal to how much? Del S1 plus del S2 is equal to how much? Let us consider this is as del S E during the expansion. So this will be equal to QR by T, right? Del S1 is QR by T and del S2 is minus QR by T. So it will be equal to 0. That means during the expansion, the total entropy change will be 0. Now let's see what happens during the compression. You can take a screenshot from here. Okay. So during the compression, the volume of the substance decreases. Compression simply means we are pushing the piston inside, right? So in this particular case, what will happen? This piston will now come here, and the molecules will be present only in this certain area. So in this particular case, the volume of the substance decreases. Again, let the system is compressed from volume. During the expansion, the volume reached to V2. Now it will compress from V2 to V1 again. Okay. Compress to V2 to V1 again. Now, in this particular case, if the volume decreases, that means it is losing the heat energy. And what will get the heat energy? Yes, heat reservoir. Heat reservoir will gain all the energy lost by this substance. So, the substance loses heat and heat reservoir gains it. Therefore, the change in entropy of substance will be del S1 will be equal to how much? Minus QR by T. Here we are putting minus over here because during the compression, the volume decreases. That means heat energy decreases, and because of that, the entropy will also decrease. That's why here we are putting the minus sign in the change in entropy for the compression process of the substance. But at the same time, the change in entropy of the heat reservoir will be how much? Yes, you are correct. Del S2 will be equal to QR by T. Why positive? Because the heat energy lost by the system is being gained by heat reservoir. That means it should be positive now. Therefore, the total change in entropy will be how much? Del S expansion, or this is compression. So del S C will be equal to del S1 plus del S2 minus QR by T plus QR by T, and it will be 0 again. So the total change in entropy, the total change in entropy in one complete cycle means it will expand, then it will get compressed as well. In complete cycle is del S is equal to del S expansion plus del S compression. This is zero, this is zero. So the total entropy change in one complete cycle for isothermal reversible process will be zero. That means the entropy do not change in isothermal reversible process. That's what this all derivation mean. Now let's see the entropy change for isothermal irreversible process. For isothermal irreversible process, let the substance inside the cylinder absorbs heat QIRR irreversibly. Let me write that. Let the substance absorbs irreversibly QIRR amount of heat. QIRR amount of heat from reservoir. So this is irreversible process. That means it is gaining the energy QIRR from the reservoir. That means it is gaining energy and reservoir is losing the energy. But there is a but over here. The entropy change of the substance or system depends only on the heat changed or heat absorbed reversibly. That means the entropy change of the substance or the system depends only on the heat absorbed reversibly. It does not depend on the heat absorbed irreversibly. Then for this particular case, the change in entropy for absorption or the change in entropy for substance is del S is equal to del S1 will be equal to how much? Yes, you are correct. QR by T, as it depends only on the heat change reversibly. And similarly, the change in entropy of the reservoir, that is heat reservoir, depends on QIRR as well. So it depends on heat energy changed irreversibly as well. So the change in entropy of the reservoir will be how much? Yes, you are correct. Del S2 is equal to minus QIRR by T. Here I am putting minus over there. The reason for that is the heat reservoir is losing the energy, and because of that, its entropy will decrease. That's why there is a minus. Now, total entropy change will be equal to how much? Del S1 plus del S2. Del S1 is equal to how much? Minus del S2 is equal to minus QIRR by T. This plus changed to minus because of this minus. Okay, so this is the value of the entropy change for irreversible process. At it is irreversible, so there won't be any compression thing at all. Okay, now from this equation, what do we see? QR is always greater than QIR. Let me erase this portion to write that. We know that QR by T, that is entropy of reversible reaction, is always greater than QIRR by T. That means entropy of reversible reaction is always greater than the entropy of irreversible process or irreversible reaction. Then QR by T minus QIRR by T is always positive, right? Always positive. So what do we conclude from here is that in isothermal irreversible process, the entropy of the substance, always increases. So this is the conclusion of isothermal irreversible process. That means the entropy will always increase. So in this video we read about two things, that is the entropy change for isothermal reversible reaction and irreversible reaction. In isothermal reversible reaction, the total entropy change in one complete cycle is how much? Zero. Yes, it is zero. And the total entropy change in an isothermal irreversible reaction is always greater than zero. That means it will always be positive. The reason for that is it will gain energy, system will gain energy in reversible way, but the heat reservoir loses energy in irreversible way. That means it can't gain energy again. So its entropy decreases, but the system's entropy will increase and it will always be a positive quantity. So this is all about entropy change for isothermal reversible and irreversible process. I hope you understood everything about this video. If you like the video, share this video as much as you can, and thank you for watching the video.